Hello children. So today in this module we are going to discuss the story The Address by Marga Minko. Marga Minko, a Dutch writer and journalist, born in March 1920, grew up in a family of five in Breda, Netherlands. Unlike her sister, brother and parents, she went into hiding during World War II. Later, she was the only one in her family who survived after the war. In 1957, she made her debut as a writer with Bitter Hubs, the laconic and devastating story of a young girl who escapes through a back door when her family is arrested, and ultimately discovers that she has lost everyone close to her. The book was a great success at home and abroad, with over 400,000 copies sold in the Netherlands only. Her experiences during the war inspired her to start writing novels, highlighting the existential problems of Holocaust survivors who returned to empty houses and wondered why they survived, and so many beloved ones did not. The writer now lives in Amsterdam and is 100 years old. Let's read about the story. The story, The Address by Minko, is a story of human suffering and destruction that war brings. Although the story narrates about loss and regret emanating from persecution of the Jews during the Second World War, like The Diary of a Young Girl by Anne Frank, but Minko, while narrating the post-war challenges of the survivors, also puts before us the personal challenges we all face as individuals in resolving crises in our lives. The story relays events before and after the war, as the female narrator attempts to confront her past when she visits the address where her mother's belongings were stored, that is Mrs. Darling's house. On a deeper level, the story is a commentary on memories and remembering on what is worth remembering and what is worth forgetting. How things lose their value when you see them again torn out of context, or which had endured all these years because they were things. The story never sounds meaningless, whether you read it in perspective of its historical background or without that background. Children, I find this story timeless and invaluable. Highlights of the chapter. Narrator standing at the door of Mrs. Darling, the address 46 Marconi Street, to claim the belongings of her mother, Mrs. S., who dies during the war. Mrs. Darling opens the door and shows no signs of recognition that makes narrator confused if she has mistaken the address. But then she recognizes her mother's green cardigan, which Mrs. Darling is wearing, and she's sure now that she is at the right address. Mrs. Darling gives her a cold response and asks her to visit some other day. Narrator is disappointed and starts moving back to station to catch the train way back to her rented residence where she resides alone after war. On the way back to station, the flashbacks of memories change the chronological order of the narration and also introduce these characters properly. Now, narrator remembers how her mother has introduced her to Mrs. Darling for the first time when the narrator comes back to home from hospital after an illness. The narrator also remembers that Mrs. Darling, an old acquaintance of her mother's name was Mrs. S., has suddenly renewed her contacts while survival of Jews in Holland is becoming difficult. Mrs. Darling has rather herself offered her help to the narrator's mother in keeping her precious belongings safe if in case they have to go to hiding places like other Jews. The narrator's mother feels grateful to Mrs. Darling's help, whereas the narrator is suspicious of her intentions. After setting the entire background, the narrator moves back to present time and tells us how she is afraid of confronting those articles or those belongings of her mother that belong to a lost connection. But gradually, after liberation, when life becomes normal, Here narrator's observation of the light color of bread, familiar views and unthreatened sleep set a contrast to the coarse stale food of the camps, the view of barren land and barbed wires, and a sleep forever threatened with pain and death. The narrator starts longing for those belongings of a mother, which leads to her first visit to Mrs. Darling's address. When her first visit fails, she tries the second time and goes back to the same address. And to her surprise this time, she is welcomed by a young 15-year-old girl, Mrs. Darling's daughter. The girl tells the narrator that her mother is out for some errand and asks the narrator to wait for her. She takes the narrator inside the house at the entrance in the hallway. The narrator can see the cumbersome Hanukkah candle stand that belongs to her mother. Finally, she has been taken to a room which she finds familiar but not familiar. Familiar because the room is filled with belongings of her mother, but not familiar as the belongings were kept in an alien atmosphere. The narrator can see her mother's tablecloth, teapot, pewter plate, silver spoons, antiques and several other things that belong to her mother. But instead of liking it, she feels uncomfortable and leaves the room telling the girl that she has to catch a train. The narrator is not sure about her restlessness after seeing her mother's belongings and gives us various reasons for feeling that way. But finally, she decides to forget the address to move on. Else, that address would keep reminding her of her sad past. Now, children, there ends the story. I hope you must have understood it. Now, here to help you out with the questions, I have given you answers, some sample answers, so that you understand how you are supposed to write the answers. In case there are still some queries, please send it to me and I'll be answering your queries. Thank you.